Okay, problem 36. Differentiate natural log of 5x squared over 4. Now, as a recall, to differentiate natural log of u, first we get the derivative of u, that's your u prime, over that u. Okay, so over here, our u is 5x squared, and then its u prime is 10x. Okay, now this is a fraction. Obviously, this is a fraction, natural log of 5x squared over 4. But since 4 is just a constant, so we can rewrite this as the derivative of 1/4 times the natural log of 5x squared. Okay, and this is constant 1/4, so we can continue on rewriting this as simply 1/4, and go ahead, get the derivative or differentiate the natural log of 5x squared. Okay, so we're not gonna be doing anything on this constant 1/4. Now let's apply the formula for the derivative of the natural log of u. So it's u prime over u, and as you can see here, u prime is 10x, that is the derivative of this 5x squared, divided by this 5x squared right here. Okay, now we can simplify this. Now 10 over 5 is 2, so that's 1/4 times 2, and then x over x squared is over x. Again, it's 2 over 4, that's simply 1/2, so our final derivative is 1 over 2x. Okay, let's go ahead and look at problem 37. Okay, so go ahead and get the derivative or differentiate the natural log of, say, 3x squared minus 4x plus 2 squared over 3. Okay, now again, this is a fraction, but the denominator is simply a constant, so we can rewrite this as 1/3 times the derivative of the natural log of 3x squared minus 4x plus 2 squared. Now, to recall, one property of logarithm, let's say you have a logarithm of x to the third power. By the property of logarithm, we can rewrite this as 3 times the logarithm of x. Okay, we can rewrite this natural log of 3x squared minus 4x plus 2 squared as 2 times the natural log of that 3x squared minus 4x plus 2. And this 2 here, this can join this 1/3. So 2 times 1/3 is going to be 2/3 times the derivative of this natural log of this quantity here, in which first you, okay, get u prime. So our u is 3x squared minus 4x plus 2. And then u prime is 6x minus 4. So once again, the derivative of the natural log of u is equal to u prime over u. Okay, so the natural log of 3x squared minus 4x plus 2, its derivative is going to be u prime, which is 6x minus 4, that's the derivative of this expression here, divided by this expression, 3x squared minus 4x plus 2. Okay, and all that's left here is simplifying. Now I can go ahead and multiply the 2 to 6x minus 4 over 3x squared minus 4x plus 2. Okay, if you wish, you can factor out the 2 from 6 and 4. All right, or you can leave your answer the way it is written over here. All right, let's go ahead and try number 38. Let's say you have to differentiate the natural log of this quotient here. Let's say 3x plus 4 over 5x minus 2. Okay, so again, the derivative of the natural log of u is equal to u prime, derivative of this u divided by that u, okay? Now, this is a quotient right here, okay? 3x plus 4 over 5x minus 2. But all we need here is use the other property of logarithm that says if you have the logarithm of x over y, it's equivalent to the logarithm of x minus logarithm of y. So using that property of logarithm, before we apply the rule for finding the derivative, first, we can use this property to rename it. So this is equivalent to natural log of 3x plus 4 minus natural log of 5x minus 2. Okay? So this is a quotient. This part of the natural log expression is a quotient, but it's not necessarily going to require quotient rule. Okay? So you can use the property of logarithm to make it easier once we get to that step, you know, in finding the derivative. Okay, so go ahead and apply now this formula over here. The natural log of u, its derivative is u prime over u. So this is the u, okay? Now u prime is the derivative, which is 3, over u, which is the 3x plus 4. And then minus the derivative of 5x minus 2, so again, that's your u. U prime will be 5 over 5x minus 2. Right, so we just have to combine these two fractions. So we can multiply this by 5x minus 2. Also multiply the top by that same 5x minus 2. And then this second fraction, multiply this by 3x plus 4. Multiply this by 3x plus 4. So we're gonna combine those two fractions together. And now they share the same denominator, which is 3x plus 4, 5x minus 2. And then the numerator will be 3 times 5x, which is 15x minus 6. Okay, minus 15x, negative 5 times 4 is negative 20, and this 15x minus 15x will cancel out, so our final derivative is negative 26 over 3x plus 4 times 5x minus 2. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and try this number 39. Okay, so let's say you have y equals the natural log of, say, 3x minus 4 squared over quantity 5x plus 1. Again, this part of the function is fraction or quotient, but it doesn't mean we're going to use the quotient rule, right? So first, look at the property of logarithm that involves quotient. So logarithm of x over y, that can be renamed as simple log x minus log y. Okay, so this one here, we can go ahead and rewrite this as natural log of 3x minus 4 squared minus natural log of 5x plus 1. Now, the other property that involves exponent is that if you have logarithm of x to the n, that's equivalent to n times logarithm of x. So we can use that second property to rename this natural log of 3x minus 4 squared. So this is equivalent to 2 times natural log of 3x minus 4 minus natural log of 5x plus 1. Okay, so it's easier now to get the derivative because all we have to do is apply the formula for finding the derivative of natural logarithm. So that's the u. So the u prime is going to be 3, u prime over u. So it's 3 over 3x minus 4 minus. So this is your u, this time 5x plus 1, its u prime is 5 over that 5x plus 1. Okay, so let's go ahead and combine these two fractions. Let's multiply this by 5x plus 1. Multiply the top also by 5x plus 1. Now this one we multiply by 3x minus 4. Also the numerator by 3x minus 4. And then, since they share the same denominator now, which is 3x minus 4 times 5x plus 1, the top will be, now this is 6. 6 times 5x is 30x, plus 6 times 1 is 6. Now minus 15x, and then negative 5 times negative 4 is positive 20. Okay? So 30x. Minus 15x is 15x, 6 plus 20 is 26, over 3x minus 4 times 5x plus 1. Okay, good job. Let's look at the question number 40. Let's say we have to differentiate natural log of x over natural log of x squared. Okay, now we have a quotient rule question right here. So we have to use a quotient rule. So let's assign this to be u, and this is our v. Okay, so if u is natural log of x, u prime is, okay, so this is like u, so the derivative of u is 1 over that x. Okay, so v is natural log of x squared, which is by the property of logarithm is the same as 2 times natural log of x. So its v prime will be 2 times the derivative of ln x, which is 1 over x. So our v prime is 2 over x. Okay? So the quotient rule says multiply u prime by v minus u times v prime all over v squared. Okay, so what is our u prime? Our u prime is 1 over x multiplied by v. So your v is natural log of x squared minus u, which is natural log of x multiplied by v prime, which is 2 over x. Now to simplify this, okay, don't forget the over v squared. So that's over ln x squared, and then square that, okay? So the numerator is going to be natural log of x squared over x minus 2 natural log of x over x, okay? So 2 times natural log of x all over natural log of x squared square that. So we can combine this numerator right here. So that's equivalent to natural log of x squared minus 2 natural log of x all over x. And then this denominator here, okay, we're just going to be multiplying this x by that. Okay, natural log of x squared squared. Okay, because this one here is ln x squared, squared means over 1. So when you multiply, when you simplify this complex fraction, you end up having this ln x squared squared to be part of this final denominator here. Okay. So go ahead and try question 41. Differentiate natural log of, say, sine x over cosine x. So this part of the function is a quotient. But again, check for ways to rename it so you don't have to use the quotient rule. Now, using the trig identity, sine over cosine we know is tangent x, okay? And this time so let me write down again how to differentiate natural log. Okay, so to differentiate natural log of u, it's going to be u prime over u. So in this case, this is your u, and the derivative of tangent x is secant squared x over that tangent x. Okay, so that's it. Let's say we have to get the derivative of a regular logarithm. So how do you differentiate a regular logarithm? Let's say logarithm of x base 3, okay, let's say over 5. So let's say your logarithm of u to base b is given here. So this is the formula. How do you differentiate that? So what's the formula to find the derivative of this regular logarithm? So the formula says you have to get u prime over u, okay, and try to compare that with the derivative of the natural log of u, okay? In the natural log of u, we say u prime over u. In a regular logarithm, it's u prime over u, ln b, okay? So multiply the denominator u by ln b. Now, let's examine this natural log of u. Now, we say natural log when the base is e. So this ln part is actually the logarithm of u to base e. So if you apply this formula for a regular logarithm, it's actually u prime over u times the natural log of e. Now, we know a natural log of e is 1. So that's why we have this u prime over u, okay? Now, this logarithm of x to base 3 over 5 is a fraction, but again, the 5 is a constant, so we can just multiply 1/5 by the derivative, okay, the derivative of the natural log of x to base 3, okay? So you can pull out that over 5, which is the same as multiplying everything by 1/5. So that's 1/5 times the logarithm of x, okay? So look at the formula here. So log u is u prime over u ln b, okay? So this is like your u is x, and then u prime is 1, okay? And the b is the base, which is 3. So using the formula for the regular logarithm, it's 1 over x. Multiply this x by ln b, okay? The b is 3, so ln 3. There you go. That's 1 over 5x natural log of 3. Okay, one more example for a regular logarithm. Okay, you have to find the logarithm. Okay, say the logarithm of x squared base 4 over 5. So once again, differentiate the regular logarithm, okay, u base b. So what's the formula? We say u prime over u ln b, okay? So that's the formula we're using. Now, again, this is over 5, which is constant. So everything over 5 is equivalent to multiplying that 1/5, okay, to the derivative of the logarithm of x squared to base 4. Now, before you apply the derivative, see if you can rename that logarithm expression using the property. So this exponent 2, okay, so using the property, we can go ahead and multiply this 2 here to the logarithm of x base 4. And that 2, again, becomes a constant. So you can multiply that 1/5 by that 2. So we end up having that 2/5 as our constant multiplied by the derivative of this log x base 4, which is u prime over u ln 4, okay, or 1 over x natural log of 4. Okay. Final derivative is 2 over 5x natural log of 4. Okay, one more example on logarithm, say 44. We have to get the derivative, okay, differentiate a logarithm of, say, sine x over cosine x base 5. Okay, so we're using a trig identity here. So the derivative of sine over cosine, we know it's tangent, okay? So this is just a tangent x. So before you apply the derivative, see if you can rename it. All right. So again, if you have logarithm of u base b, what is the derivative? The derivative will be u prime over u ln b, okay? So this is our u right here. U is tan x. What is u prime? What is the derivative? Secant squared x, okay? So the derivative of tangent x to base 5 is going to be secant squared x over u, which is tan x, multiplied by the natural log of the base 5. Okay. That's it. And let's go ahead and try this. 45, differentiate a square root of x. Okay, so from 45 to 50, let's just summarize all the shortcut and some tricks that we've been using, you know, since the part 1. Let's say differentiate square root of x. See if you remember how to differentiate square root of x using the trick. Say that's 1 over 2 square root of x. So let's say we want this square root part to be a little bit more complicated. Let's say square root of 5x plus 3. So what's the trick again? So look at the form above over here. So it's 1 over 2 square root of 5x plus 3. Now, this is a plain x, but this is no longer plain x, so that this one requires chain rule. So there's one more step, which is to multiply everything by the derivative of that 5x plus 3, which is 5. Okay, so our final derivative is 5 over 2 square root of 5x plus 3. Let's say another trick that we've been using is about reciprocal, okay? Let's say you have to get the derivative of, say, 2 over x minus 3 over x squared, say, plus 4 over x cubed, okay? So these are all reciprocals, and we have this reciprocal rule shortcut, okay? So what we do is multiply this 2 and 1 over that same x raised to 2, which is 1 plus 1. And then we switch the sign. So for this second term here, we multiply 3 and 2, that's a 6, over x raised to 2 plus 1 is now 3. And then we switch the sign, plus. And then here, 4 times 3 is 12, over x raised to 3 plus 1 is 4, and then switch the sign. Okay, that's how easy how to get the derivative using the reciprocal rule, okay? Let's look at number 48, which involve another shortcut. Let's say you have to get the derivative of this function, say 4x squared minus 5 over 3x squared plus 2. Okay. Now, this form right here is kind of like special. It's a quotient. But if you know the trick, you don't have to use the quotient rule. Okay, so you can bypass the quotient rule formula here. If you recognize that, you know, this literal part are exactly the same, that means we can use this trick, which is first, you get the derivative of that x squared. Okay. So what is the derivative of the x squared? The derivative of the x squared is 2x, okay? So the formula I'm using is this right here. If you have a times f of x, okay? I'm using this f of x here. If I have a f of x plus b over C f of x plus d. So the formula is you get the derivative of this function, which is the variable part, that's f prime of x, times this determinant ad minus bc over the denominator squared, okay, over that c, you know, f of x plus d, so that's simply the denominator and square it, just like the quotient rule, you square the denominator, okay? So f prime of x, so that's the derivative of this variable, which is 2x, and then multiplied by this ad minus bc, okay? So where is our a? A, b, c, d. So that's the a. That's the B, and this is the C, that's the D. So this 2x, go ahead and multiply that by AD minus BC. So A is 4, D is 2. Now B is negative 5, so be careful if it's a negative. B is negative 5 times C, which is 3. Then all over that same denominator, 3x squared plus 2 squared, okay? So that is 2x times, now 8 plus 15 is 23. That's 23 over 3x squared plus 2 squared. Or that's 46x over 3x squared plus 2 squared. Okay? Without the use of the quotient rule, we just use the trick. So let's do another logarithm question. Let's say get the derivative of the natural log of this 5x squared plus 3x minus 1 and then squared. Okay, so this is the u part. So the derivative of the natural log of u is u prime. Okay. Derivative of natural log of u is u prime over u. Okay. So that is 10x plus 3. Hold on. I overlooked this square here. So what we can do is rewrite using the property, so that's equivalent to 2 natural log of 5x squared plus 3x minus 1, okay? And since this is just a constant, so we can pull this out. That's 2, and then we get the derivative, okay? 2 times, go ahead and differentiate the natural log of 5x squared plus 3x minus 1, okay? Which is 2 times... Okay, 10x plus 3, okay, so that's the u prime over u, that's all over that 5x squared plus 3x minus 1, okay? That's for the natural logarithm differentiation. Okay, look at this, our last example here that we just covered involving regular logarithm. So if you get the logarithm of 5x to the 4th to base 3, okay? So we say that the derivative of the natural log of x to base b is equal to, or let's say make it u, okay, is u prime over u multiplied by ln b, okay? So our u here is, okay, before we identify the u, let's go ahead and use the property first. So this is equivalent to finding the derivative of 4 times the logarithm of 5x, okay? Base 3. And since this is your constant here, so we can pull this out. So this is 4 times differentiate logarithm of, okay, 5x to base 3. So in other words, our u is 5x, okay? So our u is 5x, and then our u prime is 5, okay? So look at the formula, the logarithm of u to base b, its derivative is u prime over u ln b. So this is 4 times u prime, which is 5, okay? Derivative of 5x over 5x. 5x times the natural log of the base 3. Okay? So final derivative is 20 over 5x ln 3. Right, so this concludes our quotient rule tutorial, and thank you for watching.